Hey YouTube, in light of everything that's been going on in the United States and in the world, shown to us by the killings of George Floyd, Ahmaud Arbery, Breonna Taylor, and so many others, I decided that today I wanted to do my part as an artist and to use my platform to talk about some of the greatest Americans who have lived in this country and to celebrate Black excellence in this country and the change that they brought through music. By the end of this video, you will hopefully receive some inspiration, hear some music, and know some powerful stories that perhaps you didn't know before. Here we go. As we get into it, don't worry. On this channel, I don't want to get too political. However, now is the time to lift up and support our African American brothers and sisters in their time of need and seeking change. Not to create violence or pain, but to inspire love and brotherhood. It's just the right thing to do. The best way I know to break barriers, protest, and bring people together is through music. So, I am going to tell you a story about one of the most consequential Black Americans to have ever lived. The person that paved the way for all Black musicians and singers after her. An opera singer by the name of Marian Anderson. Marian Anderson was born in Philadelphia on February 27, 1897, almost exactly 100 years before I was born. She showed musical promise early on, first on the violin and piano, and then focusing primarily on singing. The Anderson family couldn't afford lessons or instruction, so they relied on free help. Marian felt the strong racism of the music community for the first time when she applied to the Philadelphia Music Academy. She sat there in the room with her application in hand until all the white people had been seen first. Then, when she was called up, the young lady at the desk looked her straight in the eyes and said, "We don't take colored here, and we never will." Though she used a more offensive word instead of colored. This is what Marian Anderson later said of the incident. "I don't think I said a word. I just looked at this girl and was shocked that such words could come from one so young. If she had been old and sour-faced, I might not have been startled. I cannot say why her youth shocked me as much as her words. On second thought, I could not conceive of a person surrounded as she was with the joy that is music without having some sense of its beauty and understanding rub off on her. I did not argue with her or ask to see her superior. It was as if a cold, horrifying hand had been laid on me. I turned and walked out." This would not be the last time she faced this kind of racism. After this, to support Marian, her church gathered together and they fundraised about $500 so that she could take voice lessons. She eventually found someone that would take her for voice lessons, and she began studying with Italian tenor Giuseppe Boghetti. Because Marian would not be able to get a good start to her career here in America, she left to Europe, where they were a little less racist, and they accepted her. Everywhere she went, people were astounded by her soulful contralto voice. Her voice led to the famous Italian conductor of opera, Arturo Toscanini, to say, "Yours is a voice one hears once in 100 years. After 10 years of extensive singing in Europe, she was invited back to the United States to sing. already carrying a legendary name. However, in 1939, she was invited by Howard University to sing at Constitution Hall in Washington, D.C. This was the largest hall in Washington, D.C. at the time. However, controversy began when the owners of the Constitution Hall, the Daughters of the American Revolution, refused to let Marian Anderson sing there just because she was black. This sparked then-member and First Lady of the United States, Eleanor Roosevelt, to resign from the Daughters of America and to help organize a concert for Marian Anderson outdoors at the footsteps of the Abraham Lincoln Memorial. There was such excitement to hear Marian Anderson sing that over 75,000 people showed up to the National Mall. This moment will forever be archived as one of the first and largest public demonstrations against racism in American history. In the concert hall, audiences were segregated, but on the National Mall, every race was intermingled just to listen to the first great African-American diva.
Refusal of the DAR to let her use their hall fanned a countrywide controversy, with this great gathering as the climax. The singer was invited by Secretary of the Interior, Ickes, who attends with Secretary of the Treasury, Morgenthau. Spectators include Supreme Court Justice Black, New York Senator Robert Wagner, and a host of notables, here to listen to the voice acclaimed by many as the finest in a century.
About 30 years later, Marian Anderson would return to the footsteps of the Abraham Lincoln Memorial to sing the spiritual, "He's Got the Whole World in His Hands," right before Dr. Martin Luther King would get up to the podium and deliver his "I Have a Dream" speech. In that speech, Dr. King quotes, "My country, 'tis of thee." Coincidence? I think not. There was the very same place that nearly 30 years prior, a black American woman declared that black art, and therefore black people, would be taken seriously in America. How beautiful is that? Marian Anderson went on to become the first black person, whether American or not, to sing at the Metropolitan Opera House in 1955. She was contracted to sing the role of Ulrika in Verdi's opera Un Ballo in Maschera. That season also saw great African-American baritone Robert McFerrin perform on the Metropolitan stage for the first time. Marian was already 57 years old, and her voice was showing her age a little bit. However, there could not have been any other singer to be the first black American opera singer. The audience loved her, and history has never been the same. Marian Anderson retired in 1965, and eventually died in 1993. In her lifetime, she sang for the inauguration of Dwight D. Eisenhower, and President John F. Kennedy sang for the Queen of England, and so many other powerful people. Her awards include the Presidential Medal of Freedom, a Grammy Lifetime Achievement Award, the Kennedy Center Honors, the National Medal of Arts, National Women's Hall of Fame, and the list goes on and on. In 2016, the National Treasury announced that her concert at the footsteps of the Lincoln Memorial in 1939 would be depicted on the back of the new $5 bill, set to be in circulation sometime in the 2020s. Marian Anderson inspired so many other black people and people of color to pursue music and the arts. Without Marian, there would be no Leontine Price, or Jesse Norman, or Whitney Houston, or Diana Ross, or Beyoncé. Her success in opera broke so many boundaries because opera was, and quite frankly, still is, the seat of elite white culture. We have come a long way since the 1930s, but as we see evidenced around us, there is still a lot of work to be done. Let us not forget these great singers, Let us say their names and listen to their music. Let us support black singers in the opera house today and not belittle them because of the color of their skin. Opera companies need to integrate more people of color into their choruses and casts. No longer do we have a good reason to let one culture dominate music. Music is for all, no matter what color you are. More people would be attracted to classical music and opera if it kept up with the times and gave a voice to so many unrepresented people. If you are a singer, musician, or artist of color, I want to encourage you. The world is dark and it may seem hopeless, but you cannot stop making art. I have many black singer friends who are close to me, and they tell me their stories of how they've received comments like, oh, they sing pretty well for being part of the black species. Like if they weren't also human. Through art, we can protest as powerfully as when we march the streets. It does not have to be violent or unlawful. We can make a difference with our expression and our art to make the world a better place. Music inspires beauty and brotherhood, and we must make music stronger than ever. I want to thank the many black friends I have in the music business, in the opera world, for inspiring me and being an example despite the obstacles you have faced. Keep your head up and keep doing your thing. We need your voice. We need it. Before this video ends, I will show you a list of some of the greatest African-American opera singers, past and present, so that you can look them up and listen. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope you enjoyed it. I know this video was charged with some politics, but I just felt it was my duty to support my fellow Americans, colleagues, and friends during these challenging times. In the description, I have left some sources for Marian Anderson's biography and recordings in case you want to look her life up some more and listen to her sing. It's definitely worth your time. Lastly, if you like this video, give me a like, subscribe, and hit the bell button so that you're notified whenever I post a video. I appreciate you all. I'll see you next week. Peace and love.